not very akin to the system you follow, apparently. Though the fundamentals, after a study will appear to be practically identical. The language of sound is perhaps universal and understandable by any citizen of the world. It has got a charm peculiar to its own character. The seven notes, their intricacies, their fundamental relations, their permutation and combination, their tonal relationships, all these, as I understand, are intelligible to any civilized citizen of the world. Broadly speaking, the art of music has been developing along two main broad paths, the harmonic and the melodic. The Occident progressed and developed the harmonic system according to his own genius, and the Orient attempted to develop the melodic system according to his own genius and cultural heritage. I am particularly happy to find the Occident brethren more interested in our art, though it is mutually difficult to understand each other because of the apparent variations and developments peculiar to our own hemisphere. Indian music is very simple, at the same time very complicated. It has got a glorious tradition and history. We believe that our art has originated from the eternal Vedas, from the Samaveda, one of the main Vedas, and attribute to our music such a spiritual status which is peculiar to our own tradition. The Samaveda is a Veda chant complementing all the seven swaras. Kari sa ni da pa is a descending scale from which our music is supposed to have developed to a remarkable degree. We have got a swara system practically akin to you. The well-known 12 swaras, your flats and sharps are having parallels with us also. The sajja and panchama, that is the tonic and the fifth, which are the basic notes for any permutation and combination, have got other notes along with them, with their corresponding higher notes and lower notes. We might call them by different names, but the tonal quality will be visible and audible to any sensible man, to any developed musical ear. I am not much conversant with Western music, but still I could see or I could appreciate whenever I hear a good music some similarity with our music also. So also I find the same people taking interest in our music, and they are able to appreciate also in due course our own music. I can say with certain pride that our own friends in so short a time, round about 1 year and odd, has learned to some extent the fundamentals of our art, and he is able to sing the very simple forms of Indian music and some, a few, two or three or four of the complicated varieties also as well. He has by now developed some decent appreciation about our art also. Now, our music, as I have told you, has got a wonderful swara system, and the swaras by themselves, when they are combined in different fashions, go to build what are called ragas. The nearest term of a raga is a scale in Western music, but it is not sufficiently comprehensive to equate a raga with a scale. We call a scale a mere mela, so to say, a collection of notes. For instance, the major diatonic scale, well known to all of us, will be a simple skeleton of notes. Sa re ga ma pa da ni sa, sa ni da pa ma ga re sa. That is the simple scale of notes, pronounced without any grace or gamaka or ornamentation. But the Indian student cannot stop at this stage. He builds a peculiar concept around this skeleton called a raga. What is a raga? A raga will be a melodic form woven round this set skeleton with specific ornamentations of the notes and tonal graces peculiar to our system. And I can just try to demonstrate what it means. Taking this major diatonic scale as an example, I am using the self same note, sa re ga ma pa da ni sa, sa ni da pa ma ga re sa. These notes, when I use in a raga, will have a form something like this. Of a raga is just an outline sketch of the innumerable possibilities, the infinite varieties of expression that is possible for an artist depending upon his mood and circumstances. We have got such splendid instances when an artist could go on elaborating and improvising a single raga of this sort for hours together and even days together, continuing the sitting day by day. Now, this is practically infinite in scope. Now, returning to the fundamentals again, there are certain differences in our country regarding the application of the voice and the various tones. We in India are not specific about the so-called fixation of a pitch throughout. We can choose our own desired pitch. Each artist has got his own option of choosing the pitch. This is a peculiarity with the Western music, where you choose or you have to choose a definite pitch, international pitch. Now, your fan, therefore, needs to some 10 or 11 octaves, and you have got peculiar voices fitted for such fans, the bass, the soprano, alto, tenor, and so on. We have got also such types of voices, though we do not classify them as such by compartment. But our music is practically confined to 3 octaves. Our instruments are so designed, our voices are also so cultivated to have the span of these 3 octaves. And our permutations and our combinations, our developments are confined to these 3 octaves. A voice is said to be ideal when it can cover a span of 3 octaves. Our instruments are also having more or less the same range. Now, another peculiarity is, we Indians take the vocal as the standard, and all other instruments try to follow or imitate or get to perfection with vocal as the standard. I think that it is not the same way in your part of the country. Their instruments take more priority, if I am not mistaken. That does not mean that we do not give importance to instruments as such. We also have a variety of instruments like veena, the guttuvadyam, the mrudangam, and so on. Some of them musical instruments, some of them rhythmic instruments. But we give the due place for the instruments. We try to understand the technique, we practice, but keeping in mind that vocal is a standard and the instrument should produce as much perfected music as the vocal does. Incidentally, the vocal musician also tries to produce some of the niceties of the instrument, but that is only by the way. Even the typical Indian instrument, veena, is manufactured or constructed according to the human system. The spinal column and the bone pieces, 24 in number, as physiologists know, they are represented in the 24 sets, the belly from which the sound comes. The veena also has got a corresponding belly. Then the resonator on the left side, corresponding to our head portion, which resonates with us, and so on and so forth. This human system is called Gatra Veena, and the instrument is called Dhiru Veena. This is enough to say that we believe in the divine power of our art. If the human system is taken to be as high class and as a model, as an ideal, that itself shows that we pay more attention or devotion to Godhead. In our art also, this idea of spirituality is prevalent throughout. No music worth the name is considered to be acceptable, but for the fact that it pertains to some aspect of divinity. Our composers of repute, they have sung in spiritual terms about Godhead, about philosophy and all that. Our temples are rich with musical associations and sculptures. Our concept of sound itself is absolute Godhead in the form of sound. All these go to the fact that we Indians take to art not as a mere entertainment subject, but as a subject of deep meditation or spiritual realization. Incidentally, the professional aspect creeps in, but that is only by the way. Our model artists of repute have paved the way for the absolute approach of the arts. Now, we have got, broadly speaking, the composed music and the improvised music. And we have got the plan of the concept, and we have got other departments of art, namely the Harikatha and associated art like Bharatanatyam, Kathakali and so on. About these things, if time permits, I will continue the next discourse. Thank you. Continuing my previous talk on our great art, let me at the outset say that the outstanding feature of Indian music is its celebrated system of raga system. A raga, as I told you and explained very meagerly in my last talk, is the resultant form obtained by the various possible permutations and combinations of the acceptable notes, manipulated to give a pleasant feeling and musical effect to the listener. Ranjayati iti ragaha. So goes our traditional Sanskrit definition. So a raga should please the listener as well as the performer. How does this happen? That is our present query. The fundamental definition of swara itself is this aspect of making others pleasant and happy. Kato ranjayati iti swaraha. Its natural and inherent quality is to make others happy. That is why you get elated when you hear or listen to a musical sound emanating from a voice or an instrument. Now, if a particular single note can have this much effect, what would be the resultant effect of a combination of notes arranged in a regular musical sequence of infinite varieties and characteristic variations? Now, we have got the complete scale covering all the seven notes as well as transient scale. I use the term scale for some time to give you an idea of the infinite scope of the raga system. These scales, complete scales, are scientifically arranged some 300 years back in a scheme of things called the Mela system, 72 in number. The major diatonic scale I refer to you is called Dhira Shankarabharana. By us, he is one among these well-known 72 Melas. Another scale for your information is Maya Malava Gowda, which is the scale we begin with for any student of music. It will be something like this. Sa re ga ma pa dha
even for students to begin with, and we continue even in our advanced stages for vocal exercises as well as instrumental techniques. The ideal practice will be in the possible three tempos at least, in all the three octaves. But the beginner will confine himself to the middle octave. I'll just demonstrate.
Sa re ga ma pa da ni sa ta ni da pa ma ga re sa sa re ga ma pa da ni sa ta ni da pa ma ga re sa sa re ga ma pa da ni sa ta ni da pa ma ga re sa sa re ga ma pa da ni sa ta ni da pa ma ga re sa.
And this next part will be sa re ga ma pa da ni sa ta ni da pa ma ga re sa, and so on. Now, if the voice permits, we can also have the lower and the higher octaves. Now, this is applied for vocal practices with the prominent vowel sounds like a, e, u, a, o, that will give you the vocal strength to further development. Now, such scales we have got 72 in number, and there are other scales with less number of notes, 5 and 6, and in very rare cases 4, either in the arohana, there is ascending trend, or in the avarohana, the descending trend. The complete picture of a scale will be given by the ascending and the descending trend of notes. And the combination of 4, 5, or 6 notes along with the combination of 7 notes on one of the sides will give you infinite variety. For instance, taking into consideration Shankarabharana or the major diatonic, we have got the famous raga Mohanam. It has got the Madhyama, that is 4th, and the leading note absent, both in the ascent and the descent. So the ascent and the descent will be
Sa Re Ga Pa Da Sa Sa Dha Pa Ga Re Sa.
Now this is called an Audava Raga, a raga or a scale with 5 notes. We have got our example, Kamsa Dhuni.
Sa Re Ga Pa Ni Sa Sa Ni Pa Ga Re Sa.
The 4th note and the 6th are deleted. Now these are simple cases. We have got combinational forms. For instance, we have got 5 in the ascent and 7 in the descent. For instance,
Sa Re Ma Pa Ni Sa Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Ni Sa.
And we have got 6 in the ascent, 7 in the descent.
Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Da Sa Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Ni Sa.
And so on. All these transient scales, thus giving rise to 40,000 dots calculated for all the available 72 full scales. Incidentally, a raga or a scale like Navarasa Kannada, which has got only 4 notes in the ascent and 6 notes in the descent.
Sa ga ma pa sa sa ni da ma ga re sa ni da ma pa sa.
This is a very interesting scale which will give, or which gives, a slightly western color and we have got towards the compositions which are very much liked by even our foreign brothers. Now, apart from the so-called trampoline scales, we have got what are called vakra ragas. That is, when we have got a descent in the ascent or an ascent in the descent, we call them as vakra ragas. Sometimes the number of vakras are also more than one, ranging up to four to maximum. Now an example will be
Sagari Gama Pada Pada Sanida Pamagarita.
Now
Sagari Gama,
the Vakratva or the zigzag chord starts at Ga or the third note. Another pattern will be
Sagari Gama Pada Pada Sanida Pamagarita.
This is also another pattern of the same, another raga of the same pattern. Now, vakra ragas, according to us, can be infinite because the possibilities cannot be exhausted. The raga possibilities will be even today available for any artist to conceive. In fact, even till recent times, for instance, a famous musician was there, Patnam Subramanayyar, who is the master of my master, Tiger Varadacharya. He is famous for the invention of a raga called Kathana Kutuhalam, which will be interesting to my Western brethren, because it is derived from, or it contains the swaras of the major diatonic, and it is a wonderful raga containing a long zigzag chord.
Sare madani ka pasa sanida pamagarita.
Here, the vakra or the zigzag chord is a pretty long jump.
Madani ka pasa.
It is practically more than half an octave, a fifth downward rather. Now, this is a rough quantitative analysis of the wonderful raga system. Now, if I am to deal with the qualitative aspect of ragas, it is very difficult for me to expand it on the point, because we Indians have a very, very comprehensive conception of the raga, for centuries built. It is not the mere notes that matters. Whenever we think of a raga, we have got what a form behind. It is almost a definite word with its association to a certain concrete object. So, whenever we think of a raga, the very form comes to our mind. Such is the old and long tradition we have. But anyway, they are all the variations of the musical note, pure and simple. But such simple and pure notes are employed along with the ornamentation or graces called gamakas, and subtle variations of their absolute pitches and personal imagination and individual approaches, all these make to develop or to have developed a concept of the raga swarupa. Now, this concept of raga has led to musicians to expatiate, as I told you, for hours together and even days together. But a student should be given some guidance regarding their niceties and the various aspects. It is here that our great composers have come to our rescue. They had very broad visions of this raga swarupa, they envisage the oceanic expanse, but at the same time, for our purposes, gave us cups and even teaspoons of the vast measurement of raga. They are called compositions, simple krutis, or varnas, or gitas, or ragamalikas, or javalis, or silanas, by whatever name we call. All these different types of compositions are the production of their fertile imagination and conception, which has given us, incidentally, a concrete form of the infinite Swarupa of the Raga. Now, for this, they have taken the help of the laya aspect or the rhythmic aspect and utilized a definite language also. Though Raga, in its absolute aspect, is a language by itself, then we call as the music absolute. And this absolute, when applied to a definite purpose, to convey a definite purpose to the listeners, with the help of rhythm as well as language, it becomes kalpita or composed. It is something like the ocean water taken into a well-shaped vessel, beautiful artistic vessel. Then it assumes the shape of the vessel. Now, by studying this small, beautiful vessel in detail, I think we will be able to visualize the whole thing. It is just like I was studying a small portion of the universe and understanding it well, fully well, and understanding or visualizing the entire cosmic form, something like that. Now, such compositions we have got in plenty. The greatest composer ever lived, who composed in lakhs, was Purandara Dasa, who lived some 500 to 600 years back. He was the first person to systematize our system of music into various gradations. He is considered to be the great-great-grandfather of all musicians and composers and worshipped with reverence. His compositions go to at the order of lakhs, from the simplest to the most complicated one, though time has eaten a good portion, as is the case with any other piece of work. Now, another person of repute who lived a bit earlier to this great composer was Jayadeva, the author of the song Divine, who dealt with the love of Krishna and Radha in a beautiful poem and music, musical poem called Gita Govinda. And before that, we don't have as such compositions worth naming, as we understand at present. Though we have much written matter about the scientific aspect of this great art. Now, after Purandaradas composed the Suladis, what we teach the beginners, the Swaravalis, the simple Swara garlands, or so to say groupings, then the Alankaras, then the simple Gitas, and the simple Kruti form, and so on. Now, next to him, there were other composers like the Kshetrajna, Buddhadaram Ramadas, Narayana Tirtha, and other great scientists or grammarians like Venkatamagi and Somanatha and Sarvadeva. But an era came when our music took a very definite turn. That is, from 200 years back, the time of this accepted musical trinity, when the art of music attains the golden perfection. Sri Tyagaraja, Sri Dikshita and Sri Shama Shastri are even today and even for times to come are accepted as the trinity of musical arts, and their compositions are both for the student of music and for the layman, the Bhagavad Gita of Indian philosophy. They contain the technical perfection of the art spoken through a language at once divine, meant for the complete welfare of the humanity with the maximum selfless dedication to the highest. Their compositions are the combination of beautiful language spontaneously expressed through raga forms and rhythmic patterns unparalleled before, and their appeal is therefore nothing but universal. Any critic or student of any part of the world, I am sure, must have heard at least a few compositions of these great composers whose birthdays are being celebrated even in an all-international basis. In some of their compositions, they had even managed to exhibit perhaps their reaction to the harmonical system of music. Their simple tunes like
Ramim Varevaru Rara Gustamaninu Vina Matasura Samare,
like that.
Ninu Vina Namati Yendu Ninu Vade Sikari Hari Ninu Vina Ninu Vina Namati. Yes, good evening.